So the question was here from Danny Guerrero, Young Danny on Twitter. T-side default and overpass, always default and overpass, right? How to fade the map control back when they're running aggressive fountain peaks playing in connector, especially round 21, 22, 24. So three rounds, I will try to do my best. So let me see the round. Let me try to see what I can do to help these guys. They're called Luffy. That's the peak they're talking about. Faking short control. So when they do this aggressive fountain peak, what I'm gonna have then is the CT Molotovs here. They Molotov here if they're a good team as well, right? So they'll do these two Molotovs. So what often happens, you deny the first one, which I think is good. If you really want the control, you'll deny the second one, meaning you use two smokes for two Molotovs, which is so expensive as T, but sometimes you need to do it, right? So far so good. They deny the first one. He flashed, he denies here. But I would even say he's already passed it. No reason to deny now, right? Unless you want your teammates to come. But your teammates are not coming. So they should go with this. They should also go there. If you want to use two smokes, you have to take the control really fast back. So I think that's a mistake, especially when you think about this guy's already passed it. You know what I mean? Say yes in the chat or no. Look, he's already getting damage now. The damage is done now. He's already out of the Molo. But he's denying it. Meaning he's using a smoke, which he later could have been doing in late round. So, and these guys are not coming with him. So, okay. So the situation is this. That's fine. That's how it is. That can happen. Use two smokes. Actually, use three smokes. So you execute it later on. It's gonna be really tough. It has to be a kind of contact play. So this guy, right? Danny, my friend, young Danny, who sent it in, right? You have a flash. So what do you want to be doing here? If you know they're playing the fountain, they have done it previous in the rounds. You want to trade off each other. So what you want to do here is having this guy playing a little more aggressive. I don't know if the door is open. It's not, so that's good for you. So before you take this area, you want this guy to be in this area. So he can go here, throw a Molotov close here that burns the whole thing as they're pushing mid, because the second they get pushed back, he can cut off the rotation of those guys. You need to kind of sandwich them, right? So if he can't do that because the smoke connector or the door is open, it's kind of like hard for him, then you do like this. So you have Danny, right? Danny, yes, he's holding Monster, but what is the possibilities of the CT pushing B if they have fountain control? If they're doing that, they're not playing clever CS. Because what they want to do on B is they want to get them into B. They don't want to fight them because they know they're many T spawns still, right? So these guys are saying nobody A, meaning the guys on B are playing passive. So he's even jump spotting short. They will not push here. Good. Danny has to go back here, doing the flash above here, like you did. Find a good flash that lands in the tree here that blinds this guy, right? Because this is the common angle he has in fountain. Let me show you. This is where he's aiming often, right? So you want a flash in this area up here where I'm pointing, if you can see it. Or you find a flash that lands up here. Doesn't matter. You need to flash this angle specifically. Because what can happen, there's an AWP here as well. So he needs to be blind from the flash when you're going. So if Danny would have flashed from here, after he flashed, he could go back to B and hold Monster. You would not be in a situation where you are not getting traded. So what would have happened is this guy should also not go up. He should go close here, you know, holding this angle. So the second you get contact in fountain with two guys going up with the flash from Danny, that would be, let's see, Chris N and Zugu and Grisen would go up together here with the flash. Bang, they're both running right. They trade each other one for one. Else the flash was bad, or you didn't kill him, right? That's how the situation is. The second that would have happened, this guy could have waited 2 seconds. It's easy in hindsight, but you know what I mean. This guy cannot stay forever like this. Look at him. He's even holding underground. Meaning, if the second this guy would have to, if this guy teammates dies, he has three angles. Now he has only two, this angle and this angle. But the second this guy dies, this guy has to take decision. Either he's fighting all in, which is not a good situation, or he goes in the smoke and you traded one for one and you made it good. Okay? So that's the first thing you could have done. The second thing was you're actually going, when you denied here the first Molo, then you could have gone two guys here and you trade better, you flash a buff and you go around him and sandwich this guy. Like I said, there's been opportunities, but the one thing you did was the worst thing you could do. You went up alone. And people just ran the stream. What it did was here, Suku is flashing for Krizen. Krizen is flashing like that, going up. Trade is 3 kilometers away from this guy. You see how long the trade is. So Krizen goes up, lives the duel. He has to also pre-aim that good. This guy is now trying, okay, I need to trade that guy, right? It's hard duel to win. So you need both to go up there together. Okay? That's how you deal with the fountain aggression. So there was another question for round 22. 22. Let's see. This time they decided, okay, they're playing aggressive fountain maybe and so on. Now we need to rush connector. What's the AK doing here? Looked like he had knife in hand. So what you want to do here is basically you have one guy going, not this angle, a little to the left, so the guys can close. So his model would be like that. And now you see he kind of gets only one fight, but the guy should have been on an off angle here, like with AK here, you know, in this angle, because that means this guy could walk close here and then you could trade him, two guys, even three guys here. Now you can't trade him. He gets a kill. Now this guy has to push. You have to take the area because the chance of him being alone there is highly unlikely when you're an op, unless it's random, you know. So what can you do to stop the aggression on the ground? Like what I said, in that scenario, I would have gone off angle here. So at least you trade the guy, then it's fine. Again, Warpass is about trading. And what did I say? Trading. So what else you could have done is that you Molotov, the best bomb needs a Molotov, so he burns in the Molo, and then you just hide. Because if you put a Molo fast there and jump to the left, he has to commit all the way to the right of corner. I'll show you where the smoke is gone. So if he peeks with an AWP here, and you throw this, you know this default Molotov, everybody knows it, right? You just come here, you Molotov there, bounce off the wall, so it burns in this area. So the AWP would sit in the Molo, and you wait 3 seconds, and then you walk close. Again, that's how you get the AWP not to peek. And he doesn't want to stay in this area with an AWP. If he wants to stay, he has to go back. Again, there are two guys and they're playing together. Like they did before. They like to be glued. They're staying together here, these guys, right? So the second he would have gotten a Molotov face here, now he would have gone back up. Now he's staying because they're committed to the fight, right? And you run in, the guy is supporting with Molotov. And this scenario, SAP should have rushed. You know there's two guys. The AWP didn't throw the Molotov. There's AK. So he has to push here because there's something weak somewhere. Okay? So like I said, there's two options down there in underground. What you also can do is taking short control. Short control is always the best counter to a lot of heavy connector because they will get punished here. Or you do mid-rush. Mid-rush with the smoke you wanted to do before. You smoke toilets like you have. You come first guy here. You flash mid. Second guy denies. You go close here. You have a third guy flashing a buff in this area. So if the orb is peeking, he's blind. If he's underground, he doesn't have time to go back. Okay? That's another way you can deal with mid rush. And also just putting the motor so underground, you will deny the control of the connector guy. So the question was fountain peaks and playing connector, and there's also round 24. Let's see what happens there. Water, drink some water. Water. Mm-hmm. So again, their favorite setup, bam bam bam, good. This is one of the famous things with Opas. If you can't get the control, you always go back to B execute fast. And you have to have a good B execute. So let's see what you have here. You're pushing in, smoke fades. Is that your smoke shot? What is this execute? Is that a fail smoke? I have no idea. Looks a little strange, but maybe that's the execute you have. thing. It's fine enough. You block up short if that short control. You come in B. What flashes do you have? Let's see. Mm-hmm. All right. So the issue you have new actually is. So what do you want to do here to make this execute better, right? This flash is all right. But what if you got a flash from here, Danny, my friend? So after you did the smokes and the execute you have, and you add a flash running here, so it lands in this area. You want it to land here, right? You want it to land here. So when your teammates are here, the flash lands behind the pillar. These two guys have no chances. And you don't get blind, because you don't get blind in this area unless you're all the way to the right. But you tell the teammates to run up here. You get the flash behind the pillar here. The CTs are blind. They're hiding and you're already in their face, right? So if you make that and you execute, I think it can be really good execute actually. The only thing I see is the issue, don't have short control, meaning if they play really good on B, they will shut down monster. If they know you have to execute, they'll shut down monster heavy because you're smoking off short, right? Unless you're clever and you do the execute and you rush two guys short, you get a flash through the smoke and suddenly you're coming through your own smoke. Now we're talking. Now we're talking great CS, great content, and a YouTube video for insane tactic. But main thing is, in this B execute, add the flash here. The call, perfect. I like it. You know you can't get the control on A. They're praying three guys heavy A. You hit the right timing with the nades. But you just need that one more flash. Molo is perfect. He's burning. Unlucky you don't catch him. But if you get the flash I talked about, and the flash is coming now, you know? Now. This guy is full blind again and again and again. Same with this guy. If he's moving out, he's full blind. You push in left side. Good runway. Perfect CS. Aha, you trade good. At this need, this is not good. This is the SFB. Has to kill this guy, right? That's a kill he needs to get. Yes, he's get traded. You get the info. It's a... There's a 3 versus 2 instead. And you win the round. So, Danny, good call, I like it. And remember to add the flash behind pillar.